Hi, if you heard the word epilepsy and you have no idea what this means, then this video is for you. Well, epilepsy is a brain condition when there is excess brain electricity leading into seizures. The neurologists who are specialized in treating epilepsy are called epileptologists, and they are the best in doing so. So seizures can happen suddenly, and they can be an electricity storm going through the brain, and they can present in so many different forms and shapes. Think of it as there is a plug that is connected to the light, and wherever the light is doing, then the plug will do the same. So here is what happens. If you have a seizure in the motor cortex, then the patients will have shaking, like twitching in the face, arm, or leg. And if the seizure happens in the vision area, then somebody will be seeing flashes of lights or stars or any different forms of vision. If the seizure happens in the memory area, then you will feel deja vu or something have happened to you before. And if the seizure happens in the sensation area, you will feel pain, tingling, numbness suddenly in some part of the body. So wherever the seizure happens, the symptoms and what the patient feels will be different based on the function of that area. And sometimes the seizure starts in one area and moves to other areas of the brain. And then usually the first sensation of the feeling of the seizure is called aura, which literally means a breeze of sensation. And then it can move to other areas of the brain and goes into different areas and having different symptoms. So it starts with the aura of sensation, abnormal feeling in the stomach, and then the patient will pause and then will move to different areas until will start shaking all over, which is called generalized tonic-clonic seizure. There are two different types of epilepsy in general. The first type is called focal epilepsy. Focal epilepsy means there is a spot in the brain causing seizures. It can be one or multiple, and there is abnormality in that area, and then it causes seizures to happen and spread all over the brain. And the second type of epilepsy is called generalized epilepsy, when seizures are happening all over the brain and all the brain cells are built to seize, if you would say. Mostly, generalized epilepsy is caused by a genetic disorder when all the build of the brain is affected, and you can say like the dials of electricity are higher, leading into more seizures. And it is very important to differentiate which type of epilepsy somebody has, because there are lots of implications in the treatment, as we will discuss soon. How can we make the diagnosis of epilepsy? Well, to make diagnosis of epilepsy, you should have at least two unprovoked seizures, means that they're not provoked by anything like no trauma to the head, no alcohol withdrawal or toxins or drugs that can cause seizures as side effects. Usually have seizures without any provoking factors, and those two seizures have to happen more than 24 hours apart. And if you have those two, then you can make the diagnosis of epilepsy. The second way we can diagnose epilepsy after the first unprovoked seizure, if we can say for sure that the risk of seizures coming back is very high based on the testing and evaluation that we can do. If there is any abnormal physical findings on exam, if the EEG showed epilepsy activity, or the brain MRI and the brain imaging showed a lesion or a scar in the brain that can cause seizures in the future. And then the third way to diagnose epilepsy is that if we have one seizure and we can make the diagnosis of epilepsy syndrome based on the EEG or the features of seizures and epilepsy. All right, what can cause epilepsy to happen? Well, the causes of epilepsy can be so different based on the age when seizures are started. There are two peaks of age when the seizure starts. From 0 to 6 years old, this type of epilepsy is usually caused by either a genetic cause, when there is like all the genes present early in life, or there is a birth trauma or hypoxia during birth, or it can be a traumatic or a neonatal stroke or any like structural changes in the brain. And then we have a steady state of epilepsy happening at any age really, but there is a second peak in life after age 60 to 65. There's a huge peak afterwards. And usually seizures at that time are caused by structural changes in the brain. It means that there is a stroke, there is traumatic brain injury, brain tumors, or any changes in the physical structure of the brain leading into a scar that can cause seizures. And seizures can sometimes be genetic and run in families. How can we treat epilepsy? Well, the treatment of epilepsy is the first line, and best treatment is medications. So we have about 31 anti-seizure medications currently, and luckily, seizures will stop and respond to treatment in about 50 to 70% of the time. And as long as the patient is taking their anti-seizure medications, they will do well. There are special considerations when we start anyone on anti-seizure medications. The first one is that what type of epilepsy they have. If they have focal epilepsy, all anti-seizure medications can work. But if they have generalized epilepsy, not all the anti-seizure medications can work. Even so, some anti-seizure medications can worsen the seizures and epilepsy, and especially in generalized epilepsy can get worse with sodium channel blocker family such as carbamazepine and phenytoin medication. So it is very important to know what type of epilepsy you are dealing with. And then the second thing is that we should know a treatment of epilepsy is not one size fits all. Scheme. It means like you just give anti-seizure medications or like low-hanging fruit in any ED visits, any emergency department, they will start the patient on Keppra. Well, that is not a correct approach. We should know the background of the patient so that we can give them the best treatment for them specifically. If somebody has psychiatric history, means they had history of depression, anxiety, PTSD, bipolar disorder, they should not be given Keppra or levetiracetam because this medicine can worsen those psychiatric conditions. And on the opposite side, if somebody have those psychiatric conditions, we can treat them and treat epilepsy with one medicine such as lamotrigine or Lamictal and valproic acid in males. If somebody is of childbearing age, we should avoid any medication that can have harmful effects on the baby and the fetus while pregnancy is happening, and we should avoid medications such as valproic acid or Depakote and topiramate or Topamax. Those medications have harmful effects on the baby. If somebody is suffering from obesity, we can prescribe medication that can cause weight loss such as topiramate or zonisamide. And if somebody is suffering from alcohol abuse disorder, then we can give them topiramate or zonisamide, though both can decrease the craving of alcohol and the withdrawal symptoms. And the other consideration is that we have multiple medications working on a different mechanism of the brain. And sometimes some epilepsy types and some patients will respond to one certain mechanism and certain medication and not the other. And we do not have very detailed analysis or testing that tells us which medicine will be working for which patient. We can make educated guess, but sometimes we don't know until we try the medicine. So the strategy is we start the medicine and then we will increase the medication as we go if we have any seizure recurrence or the patient is having some side effects, we can adjust. And if the medicine was pushed all the way for a long time, enough for like 3 to 6 months, and the high enough dose and the seizures continue to happen, then we switch to another medication, hopefully with a different mechanism of action, and that can lead to better control of seizures. And if the seizures do not get controlled with two appropriately chosen anti-seizure medications and for the long time, then we might be dealing with something called drug-resistant epilepsy. And this type of epilepsy is that the seizures continue to happen despite being on two anti-seizure medications. And this special type of epilepsy that is resistant to medications, usually adding more and more medications will not help, and we go to the different type of treatment, and this can be done through the epilepsy specialized center, and we can do some surgical treatment either by resection some parts of the brain or by implanting devices in the neck or the head, and all of them are case by case basis based on the cause and the diagnosis of epilepsy. And sometimes we can go to diet therapy such as the ketogenic diet that can help certain patients. And to learn more about all different anti-seizure medications and which medication works for which type of epilepsy and how they work and interact with each other and what are the side effects and everything you need to know about medications, you can see this video that I put all the different medications in an easy and straightforward way. And stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.